Well, you know, Harry Hamlin has been a star on the stage and the big and small screen for almost 5 decades. Hard to believe it when you look at him. But the former sexiest man alive was best known for his role in the hit series L.A. Law. Harry recently opened up like a daylily on his long career, his extraordinary marriage to Real Housewives star Lisa Rinna and those fabulous lips when we sat down for this Australian television exclusive. Feast your eyes.
I'm just wild about Harry.
And it seems we've always been wild about Harry Hamlin, who was just a teenager when he first caught the acting bug.
My mother took me to New York to the opening night of Richard Burton's Hamlet on Broadway. I was like 13 and I said, well, I don't want to go, number one, to the theater, number two, to see Shakespeare.
You cannot, sir, take from me anything that I will more willingly part with all.
He was so funny and so handsome on the stage, and the audience, of course, loved it. After the play, my mother said, look, we got to go around to the backstage, and maybe we'll catch a glimpse of Richard Burton coming out. Sure enough, after 15 or 20 minutes, the door opened and Richard Burton came out and threw his scarf around his neck, and a black limousine pulled up at the very moment, and the door opened, and there was Elizabeth Taylor sitting in the back seat, and he got into the car and they drove away, and I said, that's what I want.
Harry followed in Richard Burton's footsteps, with his first role being a television production of Shakespeare's The Taming of the Shrew.
A gift from his mother, the goddess Thetis.
He then jumped at the opportunity to work alongside a couple of his major idols in the special effects epic Clash of the Titans.
Laurence Olivier, Dame Maggie Smith.
You know, the script was a little thin for that movie, to put it mildly, but because Olivier was in it and Maggie was in it, and I'm unbelievably grateful for that opportunity.
But Zeus transformed himself into a glittering shower of gold.
Of course, it was on Clash of the Titans you met Ursula Andress.
Right.
And you two became one of Hollywood's hottest couples.
It was a bit of an age difference there, but who could resist Ursula Andress?
When they met, Ursula was 43, Harry 28. The couple were together for 4 years. Not long after they split, Harry landed the role that transformed him into a global superstar. L.A. Law was a ratings juggernaut. As well as the rip-from-the-headline stories, viewers were tuning in for the latest in the romance between...
Grace Van Owen.
Michael Cusack.
Everyone says that there was great chemistry there. The ironic thing is that Susan and I never really knew each other very well, and we only saw each other when we were on the set.
Well, I got a good idea. Why don't you take me instead?
We didn't hang out together. We weren't buddies or anything like that, so... We would learn our lines, show up on the set, and do the scene, and then out of that came what people considered to be great chemistry.
Well, we were just getting started.
Look, nobody said it wasn't good while it lasted, Mike.
What made you decide to leave?
5 seasons of doing the same thing is enough. That 5-year period of L.A. Law was as though someone took scissors and cut 5 years out of my life, because you have no time to do anything else when you're doing a TV series like that.
L.A. Law viewers knew that Harry was the sexiest man alive. By year two, it became official.
I had done an interview with People magazine, and they said that because L.A. Law was so popular that they thought it might be a cover story. And then, oddly enough, I left the next week to go to Australia to do a publicity tour for L.A. Law. And no one called me. No one told me that I was going to be the sexiest man alive. It just was a complete and utter surprise. You know, it's a great club to belong to, but in those days, this was only the 3rd year of it, and everyone was going, what is that? What is this sexiest man thing? It's a kind of a stupid thing, right?
Harry was married to Laura Johnson during his time on L.A. Law. A brief marriage to Nicolette Sheridan followed. Then, in 1992, he met the love of his life.
You and your gorgeous wife, Lisa Rinna, 22 years of wedded bliss now, which in showbiz land is akin to a lifetime, really, isn't it?
So they say. You know, when I get married, and I've been married a couple of times, but I've always gone into it with the idea that it was going to be forever. And it never wasn't necessarily my choice that it wasn't. But at this one, yes, it's forever.
Every time I go off to do a film, I don't know a soul on the set.
The couple say they have few common interests, but Harry was quick to share the secret to their 22-year marriage.
Well, we really like each other, and we respect each other, and we listen to each other. And I think that's what it comes down to.
My real passion in life has much less to do with my chosen profession and more to do with science.
Now, Harry's many fans might be surprised by this comment, but you have to look no further than his aerospace engineering father to see where he inherited his passion for science.
He ran what is called then the Jupiter program for NASA. He designed the rocket engine for the Jupiter rocket, and that rocket ended up evolving into what was known as the F1 rocket engine. They strapped five of those engines to the bottom of the Saturn V, which took the astronauts to the moon.
3, 2, 1, liftoff. We have liftoff.
Having a dad working at NASA did have its perks for a teenage boy.
He brought a shoebox full of solid rocket propellant home once, and he kept it locked in a drawer, but we knew where the key was. And we would take a spoon, and just a spoonful of that stuff, you'd light it on fire, and I mean, it burned like crazy. So I was a big star under the bleachers at high school when I brought that stuff in.
Harry is now on the board of the American National Space Society, and he co-founded a company looking for an alternative energy source to traditional electricity production.
It's called TAE Technologies, and it's fusion energy, clean fusion energy, which is something that I've been working on for 30 years, which is a way to bring electricity to the planet in an absolutely clean, non-polluting way.
Can I say it's been a joy to meet you?
That's great.
And have a chat. Thank you very much. Thank you, Harry. Terrific.